The health department on Monday, March 22, logs a record-breaking number of new COVID cases, with 8,019 new infections. This is the Philippines' highest one-day tally so far. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere says the United Kingdom and South African variants are now present in all cities in Metro Manila. Vergere says, while these variants help drive the surge of COVID-19 cases in Metro Manila, the public's non-compliance with health protocols is still the root cause. As this develops, the Philippine government places Metro Manila, Rizal, Bulacan, Cavite, and Laguna under a stricter general community quarantine. The new measure bans cross-border travel and all mass gatherings unless it is essential in these areas. The area is now dubbed by the government as the NCR Plus bubble area. This takes effect on March 22 to April 4. Meantime, intensive care units in Metro Manila hospitals are reaching full capacity. Latest figures from the DOH as of Saturday, March 20, show 564 of the 802 beds in hospitals are now occupied, with no vacancies in intensive care units. This is classified as high risk, meaning 70% to 75% of beds are occupied. In related news, senators are opposing a proposal by the DOH seeking to bar companies that produce tobacco, milk, sugar, soda, and alcohol products from rolling out vaccines for their workers. Senator Franklin Drilon also calls the DOH proposal malicious and illegal. The Philippines files a diplomatic protest against China Sunday, March 21, over the presence of 220 Chinese vessels near the Julian Felipe Reef in the West Philippine Sea. Foreign Secretary Teddy Boy Loxin says he filed the protest after a recommendation from National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon Jr. The National Task Force for the West Philippine Sea earlier said it received verified reports from the Philippine Coast Guard about fishing vessels in line formation near the Julian Felipe Reef on March 7. The vessels showed no signs of actual fishing activities. They were believed to be manned by Chinese maritime militia personnel. Defense Secretary Delphine Lorenzana slams the Chinese presence. He says it is a clear provocative action of militarizing the area. The reef is located west of Bataraza, Palawan. This is the latest in a long list of aggressive moves by Beijing in the West Philippine Sea. Police arrest human rights activist Renalyn Tejero in Cagayan de Oro as the Duterte government steps up its campaign against suspected communist rebels. Tejero, a paralegal officer of Karapatan, is arrested in Barangay Lapasan, Cagayan de Oro, early Sunday morning, March 21. She was on the government's list of Communist Terrorist Group Priority Targets in Caraga region. Cagayan de Oro Police Director Henry Dampal says Tejero's arrest is in line with Oplan Kabataan of the police. The Caraga police also accused Tejero of being a member of the New People's Army and link her to two murders in Surigao del Sur on March 19, 2020. Lawyer Jose Begil says Tejero never received a subpoena and was never summoned for a preliminary investigation. An annual survey on the levels of happiness of people around the world says Filipinos felt less happy in 2020. The 2021 World Happiness Report reveals the Philippines is ranked 61st among 149 countries, with a score of 5.88. This is down from 52nd place in 2019. The report also isolates the 2020 score to assess the impact of COVID-19 on people's happiness. In this assessment, the Philippines ranks 74th among 95 countries surveyed that year. This is lower than the 42nd ranking the Philippines got in 2017 to 2019, which reflects levels of happiness before COVID-19 struck. Finland remains at the top of the rankings for the fourth year in a row. It is followed by European countries Denmark, Switzerland, Iceland, and the Netherlands. Kris Aquino opens up again about her life. In a video, she addresses the various issues that have hounded her in recent months. Kris once again responds to gossip about her sons, Josh, 25, and Bimby, 13.
In just 1 week, OA sa pagkamalicious ang pag-target sa panganay at sa bunso ko. Inisip siguro kung mag-imbento tungkol sa panganay at tawaging bakla yung bunso, titiklop na yung nanay.
Josh was diagnosed with autism as a child and was rumored to have impregnated a girl. Bimby was teased online for supposedly being gay. Kris also shares she and former Quezon City Mayor Herbert Bautista tried to reconnect recently, but she had to ask permission from Bimby.
To quote my son, nung pinag-uusapan namin, sinabi niya, "I can see Mama how you still look at him. You do not look at others the way you look at him. If he is your happiness, then he has my vote."
In a now-deleted Instagram post, she earlier said she was considering moving to Tarlac permanently because she was quote-unquote running away from love after 7 years of emotional stress worsened her autoimmune condition. In the video, she adds she sold her house in Green Meadows in Quezon City. Kris also hints her TV comeback was halted for political reasons.
"Regardless that my life's work, my chance to come back on free TV, that was taken away from me. Because I was told, mahirap nang ma-offend ang palasyo."
She says she tries to honor her parents' legacy by continuing to hope for the best for the Philippines.
"With everything that has happened, I still continue to pray for the current administration, for this government that is ruling us right now. Maling oras ito for political divisiveness."
Kris ends her video stressing she will continue to defend herself. She quotes Taylor Swift's song, "Mad Woman."
"And you'll poke that bear till her claws come out. And you find something to wrap your noose around. And there's nothing like a mad woman. Tama na. Sobra na. Lalaban na."